Just like a dream, when I whisper that I love you, and you say it back to me. Alyssa, I didn't know I needed you in my life until I met you. From the very start, we simply just clicked. We had the same interests in a lot of aspects of life, except sports teams. I remember our first date like it was yesterday. The conversation came so naturally and it felt like I could talk to you for hours. I drove home that night realizing I opened up to you like nobody else. I told you all about my hardships with PT school and my family. As we grew closer to one another, I went on more dates. I quickly realized that you were the one for me. Over the years, we traveled a lot together. I met your friends and you met mine. I felt as if you fit in with my friends and I have been around forever. You have always been supportive of me and my dreams. You know how to put a smile on my face when I'm feeling down because you're a little bit funny. I can talk to you about anything. You're the first person I think of when something good or bad happens in my life. You like to laugh and have fun, making life with you so enjoyable. There are so many qualities I love about you, but the thing I admire most about you is your big heart that you have. You have so much love for everybody around you. You're a great daughter, granddaughter, and friend. You would do anything for your family or friends, and that quality about you is so admirable to me. You have changed me to be a better person by being you. I promise to honor, support, and encourage you in our journey together. I promise to work at our love and all that I have with when we encounter hardships. I promise to always be there when you need me and to always stick by your side. When you're feeling down, I'll make you smile. When you need encouragement, I'll be there to encourage you. I cannot imagine going through life with anyone else. You're my best friend, and I'm so excited to spend the rest of my life with you. Love, always, Brian.
Brian, you are my love, my world, my drinking partner, and my very best friend. You make me laugh, you've made me cry, and the number of days in a year you spend on the golf course drives me absolutely insane. But I love everything about you. Our story began when I at least expected it to, but looking back, it was exactly what we needed. We shared a love for physical therapy and helping others. I quickly learned a lot about you, and your Facebook DM turned into hours on the phone and long talks in our cars after work. Everything seemed too good to be true. I kept thinking to myself, there had to be a catch, there had to be a flaw. Then that day came that you made it very clear that your heart bled scarlet and gray. And just when I thought it couldn't get any worse, you informed me that you had been a diehard Cleveland Browns fan. I thought there is no way I can bring this guy home to my family. I knew from that moment I was going to have some work to do. But fast forward, our first weekend together, I found myself buying an OSU t-shirt. That game at the Shoe was something I'll never forget, however. I knew you were special. The weekend I drug you to Morgantown, and after some convincing, you wore a bright yellow Mountaineers hoodie. Tailgated in the blue lot, and whether you admit it or not, I heard you chant, "Let's go Mountaineers." That's when I knew you were going to be the guy to steal my heart, and here we are today. As I get ready today, I can't believe the day is finally here. I've had so many emotions leading up to this day, and I can confidently say I'm ready. I'm ready to enjoy every moment with you today and forever. Thank you to your dad, and a special thank you to Beth Ann, who I would have loved to have met, but I feel like I have met her because a part of her is forever with you. I know she's smiling down on you today and every day. They've made you into the man you are, and I can't thank them enough. Brian, you stole my heart a year ago. You challenge me every single day, and you have made me into a better person. My vow to you is this. I promise you, through the good times and the bad, pick you up when you are down, and defend you all the days of my life. I promise to always stand by you and always protect you. I promise to put your dreams and desires above all and give you the love that you deserve. I have been blessed beyond measure, and I'm so excited to share this life and grow with you. I promise to remember all the anniversaries, continue to put snooze on my alarms every morning. I promise to always be true to myself, love myself as much as you love me. I promise to never lose faith in my teams, despite a losing record. I promise not only to be the best wife, but the best mother to our future children. And I finally promise you to be your forever best friend. Cheers to the endless dad jokes and stupid one-liners. Cheers to more trips, tailgates, memberships to clubs, last-minute Chipotle dinners, and endless Sunday fun days against my better judgment. And cheers to lots of Miller Lite, McUltra. Finally, cheers to the future. And cheers to us as we become the new Mr. and Mrs. I love you forever and always. See you very, very soon. Alyssa.
The radio in a sundress, making my world all a mess. Back corner of a cornfield, bottle tops and a true spill. Pull the lever, lay the seat back laughing, you slipping off your shoes, while the dashboard speakers sing every word of night moves. I wanna be that song that gets you high, makes you dance, makes you fall. That melody rewinds years, wants to disappear, makes time stall. I wanna be those words.
Who presents this woman to be married to this man?
Her mother and myself.
Makes you dance, makes you fall. That melody rewinds years, wants to disappear.
In the name of God.
I, Brian, take you, Alyssa.
I, Brian, take you, Alyssa.
To be my wedded wife.
To be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
In the name of God.
I, Alyssa, take you, Brian.
I, Alyssa, take you, Brian.
To be my wedded husband.
To be my wedded husband.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For better, for worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Until we are parted by death.
Until we are parted by death.
This is my solemn vow.
This is my solemn vow.
Alyssa, as I sign my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Brian, as a sign of my vow.
With all that I am.
With all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
And of the Son.
And of the Son.
Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
And the Holy Spirit.
You may kiss your bride. It is my pleasure to announce for the very first time Mr. and Mrs. Brian Standison.
Back to you on a Sunday, pouring out your heart. When the bleachers are crowded, when you're sitting all alone. you're standing in the moment.
The new Mr. and Mrs. Brian and Alyssa stand up for her.
Told me he was going on a date. And I said, really? So I started crying. I'm like, where'd you meet this girl? Tinder? Bumble? You know? He's like, no, I actually met her at work. And Brian's a student at the time. He's like, yeah, you got to keep it on the DL, though. We're trying to, you know, we don't want people at work to know about it because she's an employee. And I think my response was, ooh, scandalous. Well, that date ended up being Alyssa, who brought us all here today, and I couldn't be happier. I mean, look at her. She looks stunning. I mean, you all know it takes a special kind of woman to tame these Standiford boys. So Alyssa just meshes well with me and my dad, and I know we're both happy to have you in the family. And I know my mom would have loved you. So...
So Alyssa met Brian in the seductive hallways of Wheeling Hospital. She was a physical therapy aide, and Brian was in PT school. On one of the daily calls, she let me know that she had actually found a good-looking, eligible bachelor in Wheeling. In the coming weeks, I'm hearing more and more about him, and I could tell she was smitten. They shared flirty Facebook messages, clandestine makeout sessions in the upper hospital parking lot. I hope you can't get fired. I hope you can't get fired for that. If you can, I'm making that story up. We got her talking about what she loves about Brian and how excited she is to marry him. All of you who know Alyssa know she's not the most emotional, but I'll never forget seeing her face with a tear in her eye as she said, I just love him. He's what I want. He's everything I want. I can't imagine a better testament to a great relationship and marriage. No one in the world is perfect, and she wasn't saying that. There will undoubtedly be struggles that you two face together, but to know with confidence that this is the person that you love and what you personally are looking for and want is such an incredible blessing, and it couldn't be happening for two better people.
I'll just go one more thing. It's all Dad wants for his little girl is to find his, you know, her Prince Charming, and he's sitting right there. Just one more thing. I've always told my kids, be a leader, not a follower. Don't follow. Be a leader. But Alyssa, you've got Brian now. Brian, I'm trusting you with my little girl from here on out. Take care of her. I know you will. Raise your glasses to the new couple.